Hi, I'm Vanessa Boucher, and I'm with Microsoft. I'm a Senior Product Marketing Manager here. And we also have...
And I'm Zena Haywood. I'm also a Senior Product Manager in the Integrated Marketing Team, SQL Server.
And we are very happy to have you here today. We are plugging one of our master programs called the Immersion Program, and we're creating an MVA focused around one specific conversation that we have within Microsoft, which is called Data Insights. We're just going to be taking a moment to just kind of do an overview of what is the program, and then really we're going to be investigating how what we call Microsoft's CloudOS vision is going to assist you, the customer, with number one, adopting any of our products, understanding how all of our products work together in a solution set, and just really getting hands-on. So just taking a moment to talk about the Immersion program, Zena. I mean, you learned about this a little while ago, yep. and you saw the benefits of the program itself. And, you know, could you tell our viewers just exactly what you thought of the program?
So it's an amazing program for our sellers and our partners to take our products on the road and actually show at a hands-on perspective how they can actually use our products and see them working on a daily in their offices.
Yeah.
It's a great opportunity for servers.
Well, it's so difficult today. I mean, you know, we understand Microsoft. We have a lot of products. We have Windows Server, SQL Server, System yep. Center. We've got a lot of great offerings. And quite frankly, for our customers to really understand all of them right off the bat is a little difficult. So we're making it easier with the Immersion program. And what we've done is, you know, obviously this is an MVA. You're not going to be getting hands-on with our environment here, but what you are able to do after you do this MVA is reach out to your account executive, and we will give you access to the hands-on environment. It's about 5 physical servers connected to Azure. It's pretty awesome, and you and up to 20 of your coworkers can get hands-on with this environment and take all of our products for a test drive. It's pretty cool experience.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. So, well, we're going to kick it off. I just wanted to let you know what this program's about. And for the rest of the modules within the MVA, you're going to see that we have an A and B scenario. I think there's a total of 9 videos that we've created for this MVA. And you can definitely go through them, take a look at what technologies are of interest to you. We have some great facilitators, Gregory Leake and Russell, who are going to lead you through this environment and give you a lot of good information on the solutions that make up our Microsoft CloudOS vision and specifically the Data Insights track of content. All right, so with that, let's get started on what is Microsoft CloudOS?
Okay, Zena. So let's talk about the CloudOS vision. So the CloudOS vision, I'm sure most people will have heard of it at this point, but it's basically our vision for a unified platform across modern businesses. And the reason that we're looking into this now is that the IT market is going through a huge transformation. And there's been other transformations when we think about mainframe to server and client.
Well, it's,
and
it's
then the internet,
huge.
Right?
Yeah, everything's changing.
Well, this is, we think, going to be an even bigger transformation. And we think Microsoft will be a great partner to help customers go through this transformation and come back out the other side ahead of their competitors. Mm-hmm. We think we're a really, really good partner when we think about
So when it's transforming, it's not just the data or how I'm storing my data on a SQL server. It's much more than that. So it's, you know, gosh, so some of the technologies that I've been seeing, and I come from the Windows Server world, and I'm learning about data insights, and just, it's amazing the data, the way you can get data that you never had access to before, the way that you can combine it, the way that you can actually get insights into our customer base. It's just, it's amazing, and it works for not just these big enterprise customers, but just, you know, your normal
And it's not just
shops.
About data, when you think about it from the CloudOS perspective, you think about the things that are making this change happen. Mm-hmm. You've got the proliferation of devices. There's so many devices out there that are changing the way people work and their work-life balance. Right. They're all intertwined, and then as more and more devices are coming out into the marketplace, more and more apps are being produced, and these apps are different as well. They've got a cloud back end, they're mobile, they're just very different to what we've seen before. Mm-hmm. And those two things combined are leading on to a third piece, which is the data thing that you've just been talking about. Big data, as it's been coined, but it's just churning more and more data, real-time data, data streaming from just devices out there, just in the Internet of Things, as they call it. Mm-hmm. All of that is coming out and just giving us this amount of data that needs to be controlled. And then finally, there's the cloud, and the cloud is going to provide this scalable place to actually put all this data and all this content so that you can keep it in a cheap and safe environment.
Wow.
So it's all happening at the moment.
So we're covering everything. We're covering devices. We're covering the applications that run
yes.
on those devices, or they run within the enterprise. We're covering the big data, all the proliferation of data, and then cloud. And it is a big departure from where we've been.
It absolutely is. So these are the four things that we will help our customers with when we think about this change, this transformation out in the industry. Great. And when you think about the devices, it's interesting to think about how that's changing the way businesses think of their IT. So the business is coming to IT and saying, we've got these devices, I need to be able to use them, my employees need to be using these devices out and about. Sorry, my slides isn't updating, sorry. Okay, sorry, I'll take that again from the top. So the other important thing is that when we think about how these things are changing, that the business have to having different requirements of the IT department. So from devices, for example, they're expecting IT to empower employees to be able to work anywhere on any device and still be secure with that device and the data and the apps that they're using. Mm-hmm. So that's a very different requirement from businesses. Mm-hmm. And then from an apps perspective, they're also expecting that these apps will be updated and used in a different way as well. So again, another change that's coming for the IT department, where the business managers are asking just for different things. Yeah. All this change is happening.
That's true. I mean, gosh, the apps that are out there, just talking to some other customers, you know, the opportunity for app expansion today is yes. just amazing, and the availability to this new data stream mm-hmm. and combining that, just a lot of new exciting things are coming.
They really are.
This is exciting. Yeah.
Yes. So going back to what we were saying before as well, then this is requiring different things from the data. So as we get more and more data, we want to put that data in the hands of people that are using it, making business decisions. So what we're also seeing now is a requirement to actually have tools and data available in a way to visualize and report out on data by everybody in a business. So that's another requirement of the IT department as well. And then finally, I've already mentioned the cloud, but there's this requirement that we need to be able to scale at need, and the cloud is the place to go if you want to be able to do that and mm-hmm. to scale out when you need it.
Yeah, it's not always easy to get servers the next day.
No,
when holiday seasons come along.
So no,
understand that. All right, great. That's great information, Zina. Thank you.
So I've already said this before, but we really do think that Cloud OS is the way, and Microsoft being the great partner to take advantage of this transformation. And as you can see here, we believe that we're there today and can do many of these things. We have an enterprise grade platform with Windows Server and Azure, and I have some data in the next slide. We can talk about that. But also from a hybrid design, with one of the few customers or companies that are thinking about the hybrid solution, enabling customers to go from on-premises and onto the cloud. So we're really thinking about that and how that helps with a customer and how they're going to be delivering to their customers in the future. And very much people-focused approach. We talk about people really are the center of this transformation. Mm-hmm. It's all about getting data to the people, how the people can use their devices and the apps, where they are, when they want to be there in a secure way. So it's all very much around the people side.
Well, everything's connected is what mm-hmm. I'm seeing. And it's really an exciting time to be at Microsoft. Mm-hmm. Coming here, you know, the Cloud OS vision of Microsoft just goes beyond the data center into the way you build your infrastructure to support the data that then integrates with the applications. And then you're finally looking at the developer and how are they doing their work. And it's just a great life cycle is what I want to call it. But it's a platform, so I'm not going to get biological on you here. But it's pretty amazing just to see how everything interconnects. And coming again from the Windows Server System Center side of things into learning more about the data side of the world, I'm actually geeking out on it. It's pretty cool stuff.
It is, yeah. It's fun. So Vanessa, we just talked about Microsoft being like well positioned here. When we think about innovation at scale, Microsoft has been in this game for a long time. Mm-hmm. And if we think about it, we actually operate today over 200 public cloud services around the world. So we already do this. We have our massive data centers ourselves. And all the work that we do in those data centers and around the cloud services, we take that knowledge and put it into our products. So we're developing and using all that research to put into our products. So when we think about enterprise grade and just being in this game, we are already there. And you can see here as well, just if we look on the on-premises, some of the data here is amazing. Mm-hmm. The customers that are using our on-premise products, so Windows Server, 3 and 4 servers worldwide running on Windows, the SQL Server point here as well, 46% of customers are using SQL Server. And that's just on-premise. And we look at the cloud data, and that's the new place for us, right? And we've already got some amazing numbers. I mean, the 430 billion plus Windows Azure Active Directory is just huge numbers.
And 50% of Fortune 500 using Windows Azure, that's great.
Yeah.
That's amazing, There, I was actually just looking at Azure the other day. Mm. We have some subscriptions for the Immersion program, and the features that they're coming out with are pretty amazing and pretty easy to use.
Yep.
You know, I wouldn't call myself an IT implementer by any means or an IT engineer of any sorts, but I mean, if I can use Windows Azure and spin up VMs, it's a pretty cool thing.
Yeah, yeah, it is. And our customers are saying so too, as they're all beginning to pick it up and use. And we're talking about this hybrid solution here, using on-premise and cloud at the same time. So again, as you said earlier, it's a really interesting time to be in Microsoft and in the IT industry, of course.
Yeah, it is.
So let's just go back to the Cloud OS vision and think about what does this mean? So we've talked about these areas that we're looking at, but when we deliver the vision, we're thinking about four different areas. And these are almost the benefits that we provide to customers. The first is transforming the data center. And I know that you know probably a lot more than I do about that side.
Well, it's essentially how do you take the standard data center infrastructure that you've had running, and how do you optimize it? And, you know, I hate to use that marketing fluff word, but how do you really make it hum? How do you take the investments that you have today and ensure that they're supporting the applications that you're going to need to create in the future? Mm. And then how do those applications get you the right type of insights and data quality that are required to make your business tick?
Yep.
So the Transform the Data Center module, we have an MVA for that if you are interested. I'm going to let you know.
Advertising.
Advertising. So you can actually take a look at that Microsoft Virtual Academy for Transform the Data Center. And we're specifically looking at Windows Server and System Center in there. But here we are building out the next little block.
Unlocking insights for any data.
Any data.
Yep. And this is going back to just enabling anyone to get to visualize and report out on the data in a company. And it really is this idea of democratization of data. Mm-hmm. And it's a really interesting direction that Microsoft's taking with Excel and the other products that we have around this space. And we're going to get onto that in the next section of this presentation. The third piece here is empowering people-centric IT. And that's around using these devices, where you want to be, when you want to use these apps, and in a secure environment. Mm-hmm. So we did a lot of work around there, and I think that's coming in the spring.
We will actually have a third Microsoft Virtual Academy, and also a environment for you to get hands-on with as a customer, featuring empowering people-centric IT. So how do you ensure, as you just said, security of your devices, new ways to do desktop virtualization, a lot of great content in there, very exciting. And brings forward, obviously, the people. So the individuals who are knocking on IT's door all the time saying, I want this device, I want that device, you're going to find out how Microsoft can support you in supporting your people within your organization. So it's going to be a great module that's coming out in spring timeframe of 2014.
Great.
Yep.
Great. And the fourth one is enabling modern business apps, and that will be our final area that I think we're not quite sure when the... The timing is for that one?
I think it's going to be later this year, so probably around June timeframe we'll have that. Yeah.
So that's really the Cloud OS. What I'd like to talk through now is data insights. So let's focus in on that one area out of the four benefits on the Cloud OS vision. So let's talk about data.
Let's talk about it.
So the interesting point, and it's sort of a little microcosm within the transformation that's happening, is there is a transformation happening with data. And we have calling it here a tipping point. But basically, there is so much happening that it's just all sort of the stars are aligning at the same time, basically. So we've talked about real-time data creation, this idea of all these apps and devices sending through this information and all these sensors on various things, whether it's your electricity meter or it's from your car. There's just all this data. And because of other things like the hardware and software hardware and storage costs coming right down, you can now keep all this data. And because of that, people are able to use the data more. Once upon a time, you would have just deleted data as it got old, but nowadays people are keeping it. Add to that, there's all these different types from these apps and large volumes of data. So as we get more and more apps out there and all these different things providing data, there's just huge volumes of data available, both within companies and out there on the internet as well. People are publishing their data sets for people to use and bring in to merge with their in, in-company
combining data.
And combining data, we'll get on that later. So with all of these things coming together, there really is a convergence in making big data, like the time is right for big data, and just being able to do these new things with data, which is why it's an exciting time to be working in the SQL team as well. So what Microsoft has seen is that there's a way that people always go through a thought process when they take data and they look for getting insights, and we're calling it the data science process. So basically, whenever someone gets data and thinks about taking it through to insights, they find and combine and manage that data. Then they look at it, forming theories, analyzing, refining data, and then finally they actually report out and they operationalize and make decisions on that data. And we've seen that over and over again in small examples, as well, big projects. There's always this sort of same process that people go through. Mm-hmm. And what we've done is looked at how our products actually focus and deliver on those pieces of the process.
So how would you say this was different for all of our watchers that are going through this MVA is different from our story that we had last year?
I think the biggest difference is we have some of our products that have come out. So we have some products that do, so actually this next slide, we have products we think about making it easy to access data. We have things like HD Insight, which came out, which allows us to go and take the information for Hadoop and do some really interesting analysis there. Mm-hmm. And Power Query, another way that you can go out and get data off the internet. So we have just new features and functionality that allow you to do this first piece, which is finding that data and bringing in combining the data.
Great.
So we've made some quite big leaps in that area. The second one, and this is really where we think we're very unique here, is the powerful and familiar tools. And if you think about Excel, a billion people using Excel, we mm-hmm. have to say that we have not just the most popular tool here, but it's so powerful. And the things that we've done recently with Power Query, Power Pivot, all of those BI tools that we have, the visualization and reporting you can now do is second to none. Mm-hmm. So we have some really interesting stuff now that we didn't have and up until very recently in that space. So we really think this is one of the places that we differentiate ourselves.
No, and it is great that it's not reinventing the wheel. It's using things that people already understand.
Yes,
excuse me, losing my voice. Using things that people already understand, such as Excel, PowerPoint. Yep. PowerPoint is part of our data mm-hmm. insight story,
yes,
you'll get hands-on with that if you do our module with the immersion. So it is actually really nice that we have not reinvented the wheel with this story.
Yeah, and it's good for our customers. So they know Excel, they can go in there, they might have to learn a few new features, but it's the Excel they've always known, but with some amazing new functionality. Mm-hmm. The final piece that when we think about that process is having a complete data platform. And actually, I should probably go to the next slide for this. When we think about a data platform, when you take a look at what we have here, we have everything from Windows Server, Azure at the base as a platform, infrastructure, going up through your data management tools. We think about non-relational, relational products, so going through Hadoop, as I already mentioned.
Yep.
Stream data, we can put all of that information in, and then you've got all of the enrichment pieces, and of course Excel on the top end, SharePoint, and being able to actually share and analyze and visualize all of that data.
Yeah.
So as a complete whole, we have an amazing data platform.
So and this is a great time. I want to call this out because I've talked to some people and they're used to looking at SQL Server data in a very granular method. Mm. I want people to understand today that the immersion that we're providing you and this content is to give you an overview of the big data, the data insights lifecycle, the way that products are going to assist you with having the right business insights into your data and your customers to make better decisions. So we're going to be looking all the way from infrastructure up to PowerPoint presentations and how you make sure that live streaming data is coming through into a grid of whatever sort you want to use.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to be looking at the full gamut. So if you're a DBA, this is going to be a great immersion for you. You're going to get to be able to see things that are of interest to you, but you're also going to get to see things that are maybe a little bit out of your comfort zone, things that you haven't really thought of before. And keep a very open mind when you're going through this because you're going to start seeing how your peers do their job on a daily basis.
Yep.
And you're going to start seeing how your peers are using the same products that you use but in a different mm-hmm. way.
Yep.
And this will hopefully help you to understand the life cycle, the understand the reason why you have, Larry in the back pulling his hair out in frustration over something that you, maybe depending on your role, could actually have assisted Larry in. Mm-hmm. So we're trying to bring you together with this immersion experience, give you a very broad view, but going deep in certain areas. And so, as I said, all the way from infrastructure up to BI and analytics is what we're going to cover in this immersion.
So this is a really good chance to actually move from our intro slides, which were around CloudOS and data insights, and actually start talking more about the immersion itself and mm-hmm. what we're going to be doing here. So this next slide talks about, or it's actually a slide for having a conversation with the customer. And what we've done here is looked at what some of the top of mind problems and topics that we think are on the minds of our customers today. And the top one's interesting, unstructured versus structured. We hear a lot that big data's out there, Hadoop, they heard all the names, right. But what are they going to do? How are they going to use unstructured? And there's mm-hmm. some really good conversations to be had there. And I think even getting to some of these subtopics as well, it's a really good chance to have a conversation with your customers and really understand what are those things top of mind. And these are good conversation starters, I think.
Well, right. So, just the data quality is obviously going to be your first one. And when I would think that it would be a very scary thing for a company to start looking at unstructured data and really understand how they're supposed to be pulling that into their structured data and making sure that quality and the matching is actually occurring in a way that's accurate.
Yes.
So we have some, I know you're going to talk about it a little bit later as we go through, so I'm not going to spoil alert.
Sure,
but yeah, these are really great things, these are taken from real customers, what's top of mind for them.
Yes.
So with our solution, solutions, plural, within the data insights track and conversation, we're able to assist our customers with ensuring that they have the availability to a high quality of data. They have great dashboards. I'm so excited for people that, I know I sound like a geek, but
there's some really cool stuff in those demos.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So anyway, obviously there's a lot of top of mind issues for all of everyone that's watching today. So make sure that you understand that we're not going to be covering all of these deep dive, but the solutions that we do have do talk to each one of these common topics of mind.
Yes, and then what we did when we thought about how we take through the immersion, the hands-on labs, that's actually like a story going through, and we have people in different roles to help sort of tell the story as we go through each of the hands-on labs. And on this next slide, you'll see that we have the people, though we've got the Kathy, the CIO, through to Terry, who's the DBA. And underneath, we sort of match some of those topic areas. Mm-hmm. So you can sort of see how, as we go through, start beginning to see how this story is going to pull together, right?
Right.
So CFO is going to care about whether the reports have got, the data is right, and it's in a way that can be easily consumed and things like that. So you can begin to see how these topics line up to different mm-hmm. people in the organization.
Because IT is completely connected. I mean, you have Kathy, our CIO. So these, for everyone that's watching, these are all of our characters, as mm-hmm. Zina just said, that are in all of our immersion experiences. So we do urge you, as you're actually going to be getting hands-on with this environment once you request it from your Microsoft representative, and also as you go through the MVA modules, identify with one of these characters. Are you Hank the CFO? Because if you are Hank the CFO and you're watching this, you're actually going to learn a lot about this. Are we going to get a little bit down into the weeds with some information about technology? Yes. But you're actually going to have some really great ideas to take back to your business to help you do better.
And as you've said, we've had feedback from where we've used this with customers and saying, wow, mm-hmm. that wasn't my job, but it was great to see what other people are doing. How they are using the products and what they see and what their job is like.
Exactly.
So it's been an eye-opener in that way.
It's great. So definitely figure out who you are from this list, because as you go through the scenarios, you'll be able to see what would be something that you would be doing on a daily basis compared to your peers.
Okay.
And managers.
So let's start looking at what we're going to be showing in the immersion itself. So Contoso is the data that we're using, and a lot of you may have seen Contoso, some of that data before, because we've used it in many hands-on labs and demos before. But this is to show a little bit around that high-level story of what we're going to show in the immersion. So along the bottom, you can see the types of data sources that we're going to work with in the immersions in these other eight labs that on the MBAs. And as you can see, Contoso has relational database in here in their bricks and mortar locations.
Point of sales,
And the example here, we have point of sales. And also they have relational database in their weblogs. So they'll be using both of those types of data in the immersion.
And now you're going to understand why their relational data is going to be stored in their on-prem, while their relational web sales, which maybe perhaps is coming from all around the world, they're actually going to be using Windows Azure to store that data source.
Yes. Yep. There's one other type of data that we'll be using in the immersion, and that is off the internet, from Wikipedia. We'll be pulling in some sensor data. Mm-hmm. So we'll be able to see how all of those data points are used and combined as we go through this immersion. So. Mm-hmm.
And that will be stored in our blob store, so you're actually going to get to understand what that is if you've never heard of that. It is really what it's called. So you're going to actually get to see what that looks like, and why would you actually store it in that blob store over, you know, taking up space mm-hmm. on your on-prem. So yeah. We're going to discuss that as well.
Okay, and then we're going to take lots of this data from where it's stored, whether it's on the internet or on LTP, on-premise, or a service provider, and we can combine that data. And then once it's combined, we'll be putting it back onto data warehousing, and then, of course, out onto reports for the business users to use, and, of course, IT mm-hmm. as well.
Yep. So we're looking all the way from the data source, how we set up the infrastructure, and how yep. different infrastructure works differently mm-hmm. for the type of
yeah.
data.
When do you use on-premise? When would Azure be the right place? Yeah. How can you use one as a backup to the other?
Exactly. And then our combining. So again, all of our products, SQL Server, Azure SQL, Analysis Services, Excel, HD Insight, how all of these things come together and they're connected. It's yep. no longer I have one product and it just churns out. Mm-hmm. You know, we have a full solution. We have the data platform for
yes.
you.
Yep.
So we're going to see that. And then looking at the SharePoint Excel piece, mm-hmm. I think is really nice for anyone that's on the BI side. It's pretty amazing
yes.
what we can do in making sure that data that's coming straight off of the wires, I'm going to say, can be directly pushed into that SharePoint receptacle mm-hmm. for your CFO, CIO to have on-demand access.
I think going back to the earlier point is that if you've done all the work at an IT level, mm-hmm. actually seeing what happens in SharePoint and in Excel, seeing, well, this is what happened to that data that I was working on, this is the output. It's always quite nice to make that link as well,
right,
to
yeah.
see that.
Mm-hmm.
So, and you can do all of that as well. So SharePoint, Excel, right back through SQL, and Azure and Windows.
Yeah. It's pretty cool. So you'll get to see it when you get hands-on with the Immersion program again, and also in the following 8 modules mm-hmm. of this MVA.
So final slide, just go a bit more deep on what's in these modules. We've mentioned there are 8, and they're split into 4 separate areas, 4 experiences, 2 modules in each. First one is structured data, and here we'll be looking at resiliency and reducing failover. That's our module 1. Module 2 of our first experience, again looking at structured data, is looking more at how you would back up using SQL Azure database.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Then experience number 2 is unstructured data. Here we'll be looking at setting up and loading data into Azure storage containers. And the second one in that experience is processing data through HD Insight.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a really interesting one, because you haven't seen HD Insight. It's a really cool place to be and see. It's right
it
on the edge of that,
right? It's actually
pretty
cool.
Yeah.
I have to admit. And then third, combining data,
yeah,
so my favorite thing.
It's good fun. The combining one's good. When you're taking the structured data, the unstructured data, then bringing in that data from the internet as well and merging it all together, and then on the second one of that, making your OLAP cubes and tabular. It's really cool, that stuff,
yeah,
too.
Which, and finally, gaining insights.
Insights, yeah. This is probably the best from a visual perspective. It's taking all of that data that we've used and massaged and stored and backed up, actually then using that and producing power pivots and looking at power map, so mapping some of that data, putting it on SharePoint, showing how we can put this data into a PowerPoint slide and it gets updated when it gets updated back on the server. Mm-hmm. It's just really cool just seeing how you can deliver some of that information.
So
just
it comes full circle.
Fabulous. Yeah, full circle, yep. Yeah.
So for all of our viewers, that slide that was just being presented, if you saw A and B, the first at the, what is it, structured data, excuse me, story A is going to be the next video mm-hmm. in this MVA, and
yep.
story B will be the next and following. So feel free to go in order to get the entire immersive experience, or you can feel free to pick the module which is of most interest to you. So.
Yeah, we just hope everyone has great fun.
Yes.
Looking at the other modules and these hands-on labs, because I think you'll learn a lot and be in a great position to go out and talk more about the data platform and the Cloud OS.
Yeah. Let us know how it is. Feel free to enter the amount of stars and feedback. We would love to hear it. And also reach out to your Microsoft account representative. We are more than happy to allow you as customers and also partners of Microsoft to get hands-on with our immersion environment so that you yourself can prove exactly what our solutions can provide to you today. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.